And we are back. Chuck Harder for the people. With us is Dr. Frederick Vagnini. Doctor, are you there? Okay, we're trying to get him to the phone right now. And we'll find out what in the world he has on his mind. I know he's written a couple of books. And, you know, very often we talk about health on this broadcast. And Americans are a rather unhealthy lot. I stopped going to fast food restaurants several months ago. And I eat very, very simple fare. A lot of fruit, and I think I feel probably better for it. I have nothing against the people who run the fast food restaurants, but I don't know that the stuff that they sell is that good for me. Dr. Frederick Vagnini has written a book on healthy heart and also side effects. And, Doctor, are you there? Welcome.
Check to see if you got additional blood.
Hello, doctor. Are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Thank you for taking time out of your day.
I would have given you more time, but I had a few emergencies here today.
I understand. Tell us about your two books, what they're all about.
Well, my latest book, The Side Effects Bible, I think is one of the most important pieces of work I've done in my 35 years of medical career. And basically, it's a book that gives the nutrient deficiencies with every drug. And as you know, just about everyone over 50 and probably under 50 is on some type of drug therapy, whether it be for blood pressure, arthritis, stomach problems, cholesterol, fatigue, or whatever. And we found that these drugs will cause a depletion of nutrients, which makes the problem worse or give side effects. On top of that, you have the over-the-counter industry, and I don't have to tell your listeners, when you go down the drugstore or the supermarket, there is an over-the-counter remedy for everything, engaged from arthritis, for stomach problems, for gas, for indigestion, colds, coughs, and hemorrhoids, and everything else. These two create nutrient deficiencies, and my book, The Side Effects Bible, which, by the way, is available on Amazon, in your bookstores, and it's been selling very good because everybody's on drugs. Your listeners may also get it from my website, which is Vagnini, V-A-G-N-I-N-I.com, and as a special offer to your audience, we'll offer them, if they check my website, they can get a free monthly newsletter. So the book has been a very important piece of work.
Well, I'm one of those strange guys over 55 that, believe it or not, worked his way off of all medications.
God bless you.
The only thing I do take once in a while is a couple of aspirins to help me sleep at night. That's
right,
it.
Right.
That's it.
Yeah. Well, you're unusual. And you know something? Drug... Perfect couple of examples of CoQ10. Now, everybody knows is important for heart and energy. That's depleted if you happen to be on a statin drug such as Lipitor or Zocor. And God knows everybody and their uncle and aunt is on a statin drug. If you're on a diuretic, you get depleted from vitamin B1 and magnesium. If you're on an anti-inflammatory, you get depleted on folic acid. So these things are important because the drugs themselves can cause side effects, but then on top of that, the nutrient deficiencies can also cause a side effect.
Is there, in your mind, a magic bullet type of a one-a-day vitamin pill that people ought to think about?
Yeah, yes and no. You can forget about the American diet. No one is on the proper diet of the right amounts of fruits and vegetables, whole grains, healthy proteins. The food, first of all, is toxic because of the chemicals in the food. The nutrients are not in the foods because they're taken out of the earth and flash frozen and chemicalized. You can't afford organic foods because it's just not feasible. If you get organic food, it's expensive. And unless you eat it right away, it goes rotten because there's no preservatives. Not that I'm against organic foods. I'm not. It's the way to go. So the diet is very lacking. And I did vitamin and mineral testing many years ago, and I found multiple nutrient deficiencies in normal people. Everyone should be on a high-potency multiple vitamin multi-mineral formula. And I don't mean the ones that are sold over-the-counter, which have virtually nothing in them. I'm not going to name any names like Centrum and things like that, because I just don't want to name them. Oh, I think they named them by mistake. These vitamins have very minimal amounts. You need a high-potency multivitamin multi-mineral. Now, my program that I've developed at my centers in New York is what program what I call cardio nutrition. In other words, beyond a multiple vitamin, years ago the New York Academy of Sciences had a meeting called Beyond Nutrition or Beyond Vitamins. In other words, the use of nutrients beyond general good health. For example, if someone comes into me and I have a high cholesterol, a lot of my patients do not want drug therapy. So I say, well, we have vitamins or supplements that will lower cholesterol. I say, but doc, I'm already taking vitamins. No, there are certain nutrients such as the compound called red yeast rice, such as niacin, such as fiber supplements, such as Google lipids, such as citronol, such as panthenine, such as omega-3 fatty acids, which will help with lower cholesterol. Similarly, there are nutrients that will help with high blood pressure, heart disease, and fatigue, and so forth. So you can take a good multivitamin. For most people, say if they don't have a problem, they can take a good high-potency multiple vitamin. And, of course, all women should be taking calcium and magnesium. That's a given. And then everyone probably should be taking some omega-3 fatty acids because no one eats enough fish. And, coincidentally, the fish now is toxic, especially when you're getting into things like farm salmon, which is a known toxin now from the PCBs. And they have artificial colors in them, and they don't have the right amount of omega-3 fatty acids. So there is one magic bullet. It is the right diet and exercise. And then, of course, in this country, too, we're facing the obesity diabetes epidemic, and people are just getting fatter, and they're developing what we call the metabolic syndrome, which I'll give you a heads up. That's going to be my next book coming out in the fall. But getting back to the side effects Bible, I think it's an important piece of work because even people that are on the things, everybody's also on these H2 inhibitors like Nexium, Prevacid, Zantac. Not that they're bad, but they cause nutrient deficiencies. And hey, it's very rare for me to get people coming into my office. I happen to have two sitting right in front of me during this interview that are in pretty good shape. They're not like falling apart, tired, weak, and a normal weight, which is unusual. But there's a whole epidemic of individuals or what I call the walking wounded from toxic metabolic overload, many of them from drug side effects. And that's why I would highly recommend that your audience go out and either go to the library or, more importantly, read the book, The Side Effects Bible, because it affects everyone that is on drug therapy.
All right, doctor, I have a two-minute timeout, if you'll allow me to take that, please. When we come back, I'd like you to comment on what is concerning to me, and that is the fact that the American fast food diet, the sugar drinks, we're going to have a terrible amount of type 2 diabetes kids who are going to be basket cases and on public welfare.
Okay, I'm very happy to address
that. Yeah, we'll be right back in 2 minutes. Hang on, Doc, right after this.
It's bad enough if you suffer asthma, but as a parent, the agony of watching your child struggling for breath must be agony beyond measure. What if there was a natural, effective, drug-free answer to asthma? You'd want to know, wouldn't you? Well, I've been reading up on a little-known clinical trial at a major hospital that suggests you can be rid of asthma symptoms, and sinus and allergy symptoms to breathe easily, calmly, and in a more natural, relaxed way. It's guaranteed, or you get your money back, and you've got 90 days to decide. Look it up for yourself online at healthstarproducts.com. H-E-A-L-T-H, healthstarproducts.com. You've got 90 days to decide if this program works for you. If it doesn't, you get your money back. Go to www.healthstarproducts.com. I know you've heard me talk about Margie Garrison, the arthritis lady, but have I told you about the time she was thrown out of an arthritis convention for telling the truth that most arthritis sufferers attending that convention didn't need the expensive and maybe dangerous drugs and treatments they were being sold? Man alive, did they hustle her out of there, pronto? This might not work for absolutely everybody, but if you get Mrs. Garrison's program and give it a try for a year and it doesn't end up ending most of your pain, ask for your money back. Look it up for yourself online at healthstarproducts.com. That's H-E-A-L-T-H, healthstarproducts.com. See what the doctors are saying about Mrs. Garrison's program and if this works for you or a member of your family.
Dr. Frederick Regnani with us, author of both Healthy Heart and The Side Effects of Bible. Doctor, what are your thoughts about what I see as a new American tragedy?
You've said it all. You've said it all already. First of all, on the cover of Newsweek last year, I look at it, and there it says, new epidemic. It was an individual. Diabetic. It was as it turned out, it was a 10-year-old child, weighed 225 pounds with diabetes. The American, this country is going down the health trail drain, because of lack of care, obesity, and poor diet in our children. First of all, diabetic disease, hyperinsulinemia, metabolic syndrome is a genetic disorder complicated by poor lifestyle choices, the American diet, and lack of exercise. The children today are on all the on all the wrong foods, like you said, the fast foods, which are high in saturated fat, foods that are high in simple sugars, cereals, fruit juices, sodas. We've never been fatter. And I have a slide that I give in my lectures that shows that through the years, the incidence of obesity is rapidly on the upcline, and right on top of that, following right along the same line, is the rise in diabetes. The unfortunate thing is that there are millions and millions of people that are pre-diabetic or undiagnosed diabetics, because diabetes, hypertension, hypercholesterolemia are what we call silent killers. You don't know you have it. You don't know if your blood sugar is 200. You don't know if your cholesterol is 300. You don't know if your blood pressure is 180. The only way you find out is by going to your doctor. And sometimes the simplest things, like the right diet and exercise, are the hardest to do. Because why? Because the American public wants it all handed to them in a pill form. But I got news for you. If you're eating bacon, cheeseburgers, mashed potatoes, apple pie and ice cream, pepperoni pizza, in the afternoon with a breakfast of, cereal, fruits, bananas, orange juice and milk, you're killing yourself. And you know, and then when someone gets a heart attack at age 50, they'll say, oh doc, you know, this doctor's killing me, maybe take a bypass. Hey, you know what? It's not the doctor's fault. What did you do for the last 25 years? Not to speak of smoking, lack of exercise also, and stress, of course, which is a tremendous problem. I don't know in your state, but I know in New York, we're renaming it the stress state.
Well, you know, doctor, you've got something there in New York State. You've got a wine industry that has a particular grape, the Catawba grape, that apparently has fantastic cleansing potential for the arteries.
Yes, absolutely. As a matter of fact, we're finding out more and more of these nutrients. There are certain grapes that have a tremendous blood vessel wall enhancing effect. Recently, cranberries have been found. It's also been pomegranates. A lot of these natural therapies are good. And my practice, I try to go with natural therapies.
Well, you can tell your patients that I have, for the last 30 years, every night before I go to bed, I drink about 8 to 12 ounces of New York State Catawba, the sweet, dark grape wine that you make up there.
Yes, yes, I'm familiar with it.
Yeah, and recently I went in for not only a sonogram, but also a, what do you call it, when they do the whole body scan.
Yes.
And I just got done with a blood test, and the doctor looked at me, and I had an EKG, and he said, "Do you realize that you have the body of about a 21-year-old guy?"
Wow.
And I said, "Thank you." I have a brother-in-law who just died. He had a bypass operation. He ate, of course, now I will eat no beef.
Right.
No beef or any, I will not eat any meat unless it is cooked in water. And all the fat must come off of it before I will eat any of the meat. And I've done this all my life. When I cook a hamburger, I cook it in a skillet with 2 to 3 inches of water, turn it 4 times, and I will not eat the hamburger until I know that all the fat is out of the meat.
Beautiful, beautiful.
And I've done this all my life.
Well, you know what? You're taking the time to take care of yourself. I really have to apologize. I have a couple of emergencies
in
the office.
You
I have to cut the interview short, but I'll come back if you'd like.
Well, we'll do it another time, but listen, you take care and God bless.
Let me give your listeners my website so they can order the book if they like, in any one of my books, and they can sign up for that free newsletter. It's Vanini, VAGNINI.com, and thank you so much. I'm sorry I got to cut you short. And the name of the book is Side Effects Bible. Every listener should run out and buy it.
Doctor, we'll talk again soon. I appreciate it. Good luck and Godspeed. You bet. All right, I'm Chuck Harder for the people. When we come back, I've been reading all of the news wires today, and I have a most unusual story to share with you after this break. I have had a quiet relationship for probably, 20 years with a reporter in Washington, D.C., one of the deans of the reporters in Washington. And I read the most unusual story today, and I can't say that I misunderstand the story. I'll share it with you as soon as we come back from this time out. Chuck Harder for the people. More to come.
The year is 1951. The Korean War is reaching a bloody stalemate. President Truman fires General MacArthur for advocating the bombing of Red China.
I have considered it essential to relieve General MacArthur so that there would be no doubt or confusion as to the real purpose and aim of our policy. General MacArthur is one of our greatest military commanders. But the cause of world peace is much more important than any individual.
MacArthur was cheered on his return to the United States. He was welcomed by ticker tape parades, and on April 19th addressed a joint session of Congress.
Turned over many times since I took the oath on the plane at West Point, and the hopes and dreams have long since vanished. But I still remember the refrain of one of the most popular barrack ballads of that day, which proclaimed most proudly that old soldiers never die. They just fade away. And like the old soldier of that ballot. I now close my military career and just fade away.
U.S. troops in Korea halted north of the 30th parallel as peace talks began. In science, the heart-lung machine was invented. And overseas, Winston Churchill's conservatives returned to power in Britain after 6 years of Labour government. And that's our flashback to the year 1951.
I read all of the news wires every day, the newspapers, and you name it. And, of course, I get a lot of stuff in the mail, but I read a lot of stuff on the Internet. I know where to go and where to find it. The lady that has been probably the dean of White House reporters, and she was not all that happy about what Clinton did and his lies and what have you, but she has been heartbroken over the fact that George Bush has not kept his promise to the American people. Her name is Helen Thomas. Helen is probably in her early 80s, a veteran reporter. She has a deep passion for the American people and has seen the American people, pardon the expression, get screwed ever since Jimmy Carter. Oh, Nixon was not a sweetheart either. Dick Nixon gave the electronics industry away to Japan. If you're old enough to remember, during his farewell address, our great President Eisenhower told us to beware the military-industrial complex. He said, beware of it, they will take over the country. And of course they have. The military-industrial complex has totally taken over Congress. They buy and pay for Congress. One company now owns 1,200 radio stations and controls hundreds or maybe thousands more, we don't know. We have lost independent newspapers. There's only a handful of independently mom-and-pop-owned newspapers left in the USA. The rest of them are all owned by giant chains. What you see and what you hear, for the most part, comes from 6 different media companies who all have interlocking ownership. America is in perilous trouble. Helen Thomas said this morning, she said, if Dick Cheney runs for president after Bush, she said, I'm going to commit suicide. She just couldn't take it. Because of the fact she understands it's not just Dick Cheney, it's not just George Bush, it's Bill Clinton, it's Hillary Clinton, it's the Democrats, it's all of them, it's Tom Foley on the side of the Democrats and Bob Dole on the side of the Republicans. They are all super, super, super millionaires. Every one of them are members of the I've Got Mine Club. I've got mine. I don't care about you. Why, you American working people, why, we look at you like lab rats. You know, if the scientist conducts an experiment and the lab rats die, you go buy more lab rats. They're expendable. Well, Helen Thomas said something this morning that really, really touched me. She said, if Dick Cheney runs for president after Bush, she said, I'm going to commit suicide. Isn't that interesting? I don't think she'll have to, because I think we'll be in a terrible long recession or depression by then, and we'll see a whole new paradigm, a whole new landscape in politics. Ross Perot, where are you when we need you? I'm Chuck Harder saying thanks for being with us. Thanks for you up and down the radio trail. God bless the troops.